Praise the Lord, dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to Spiritual Nourishment for the Soul. The topic I would be preaching on is fasting from food and feasting on the Word of God. Matthew 6:16 to 18 tells us, "When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that you may not appear to others to be fasting, except to your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you." Fasting is one of the most helpful disciplines for spiritual life in Christ. Going without food for a period of time is a tangible way to practice self-denial and open up space in our body and soul to engage more deeply with God. There are numerous circumstances that have prompted God's servants to fast throughout history. And the New Testament teaches that fasting is an indispensable spiritual tool for Christians today. Fasting is a primary way to practice self-denial, and then we have the opportunity to apply this to other problem areas. Fasting teaches temperance and self-control, and therefore teaches moderation and restraint with regard to all our fundamental drives. Ezra proclaimed a fast when the Jews faced a hazardous travel situation as they returned to Jerusalem from their exile in Babylon. While the desire for safe travel was the immediate reason for the fast, Ezra stated the ultimate goal in Ezra 8 verse 21, that we might humble ourselves before God to seek from Him the right way for us. When Jonah preached to the Gentile city of Nineveh, the whole city came together and fasted in an incredible act of repentance. The king of Nineveh ordered every person and their animals to fast and cry mightily to God. God was moved by their reverence and showed mercy by not destroying the city. David fasted to seek God's healing for his sick child. It was during this intense 7-day fast that David wrote Psalm 51, which is one of the most heartfelt expressions of repentance in the entire Bible. The overall purpose of David's fast was not to get God to do what he wanted, but rather to be humbled and reconciled with God as he beseeched him in prayer. Even though God chose not to save the child's life, the fast still served its purpose of bringing David closer to God after being separated by sin. Cornelius, a righteous man, worshipped God with fasting. The fast of Cornelius opened the door for Peter to begin preaching to the Gentiles, which was a vital step in the spread of the gospel throughout the world. Jesus saw fasting as so important and basic to a life of worshiping God that he taught it as one of the three main disciplines for the spiritual life, setting it alongside of almsgiving and prayer in the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus taught us that man does not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Jesus spoke these words of reality. He was speaking the reality that he was experiencing. The truth is that in his 40 days of solitude in the hot desert, he was feeding his body and soul on the manna from heaven. In his wilderness fast, Jesus wasn't at his weakest point, but he was at his strongest point. He showed us that fasting is feasting in the Lord. The fasting is feasting idea. With practice, we can grow to experience that fasting is not as much a deprivation of food as it is a provision of food, an unseen food which is the bread of heaven. We fast in order to direct our attention and energy away from our normal source of food and onto our heavenly source. We fast from food in order to feast on manna. When we begin to fast, we will feel physically hungry or deprived of whatever we are abstaining from. Our opportunity at that point is to let our growling stomach remind us of how hungry we are for God and His Word. The words of God are far more than just wise and lovely. They are a real life-giving substance. The book of Prophet Isaiah gives us the litmus test for fasting, sharing our food with the hungry and the oppressed. Fasting is a way to learn to break free from sin. The Apostle Peter taught us, "He who has suffered in his body is done with sin." When we go without food for a time, we are taking on a small degree of bodily suffering in order to train ourselves that our belly is not our God. All the disciplines of abstinence are types of fasts in which you practice denying yourself something you want in order to make space in your body, soul, and schedule to more deeply and lovingly engage with God. Fasting is feasting when it helps us to concentrate in prayer and meditate deeply on Scripture to love God, be loved by Him, and share His love with those around us. Fasting is a tool that has been widely used by God's people throughout history, and it continues to be a powerful way for Christians to deepen their relationship with God. As we have seen, it is appropriate to fast when faced with temptations, trials, or potentially dangerous situations. Fasting can also accompany heartfelt repentance, enhanced prayer, or be offered as an act of deep worship and praise. Fasting will train us to be devoted to Lord Jesus and to be more like Him, more loving to other people, even in the most difficult situations of our lives. May Jesus Christ be praised at all times. Have a blessed day in Jesus' name. This is Pearl Rodriguez from Kadosh Marian Ministries. God bless you all.